The United States Air Force has just received a fighter jet unlike any other. At first glance, it looks like a standard F-35A. The same stealth shape, the same sharp angles, the same iconic presence in the skies. But beneath its skin, this aircraft is something entirely different. It isn't designed to deploy bombs or engage in dogfights. In fact, it may never fire a shot in combat. Its true mission is far more important. This is the world's only specially instrumented F-35A, a jet transformed into a flying laboratory, packed with sensors, wired with hidden data systems, and monitored from nose to tail. This aircraft doesn't just fly, it records. Every vibration, every heat signature, every flicker of electronic activity is captured and analyzed in real time. And why? Because the F-35 program is entering a critical moment. For years, the aircraft has faced delays, setbacks, and criticism. But the Air Force is betting everything on the next leap forward. Technology Refresh 3, the digital heart that will unlock the fighter's future. Without it, the F-35 can't evolve. With it, the jet becomes the gateway to weapons and systems the world has never seen before. That's why this single aircraft matters. It isn't just another stealth fighter. It's the prototype of the future. What happens inside this one jet at Edwards Air Force Base could decide how the next generation of wars will be fought and who will win them. Because in the end, this F-35 isn't about today's battles, it's about tomorrow's. For nearly two decades, the F-35 has been the centerpiece of American air power. It was sold as the fighter that could do it all. Stealth, electronic warfare, intelligence gathering, and combat rolled into one. But along with the praise came controversy, spiraling costs, endless delays, and critics who argued it could never live up to the promises. Yet despite those challenges, the jet became the backbone of not just the US Air Force, but the air forces of more than a dozen allied nations. Today, it's the most widely deployed fifth-generation fighter in the world. Which raises the question, if the F-35 already dominates the skies, why create a version that isn't meant to fight at all? The answer lies at Edwards Air Force Base in California. There, the legendary 412th Test Wing is responsible for pushing every American fighter to its absolute limits. And now, they have something no one else does. The only F-35A in existence that's been rebuilt as a flying testbed. This jet isn't about combat, it's about discovery. Engineers wired it with sensors across its frame, built custom data links to capture every moment of flight, and designed it to analyze not just how it performs, but how it fails. That's the point. Every glitch, every stress fracture, every software hiccup, it all becomes data. In other words, this F-35 doesn't exist to win battles today. It exists to prepare the F-35 for battles that haven't even begun yet. And the key to that preparation is something called Technology Refresh 3, a transformation so critical that without it, the jet's future is in doubt. If you strip away the sleek design of the F-35, what makes it powerful isn't just its stealth or its weapons, it's the brain inside. The fighter's ability to gather information, process it faster than an enemy, and then act before the opponent even knows what's happening. That's what gives it the edge. But here's the problem. The brain the F-35 was built with is already outdated. Its processors are too slow, its memory too small, its displays too limited to handle the demands of the future. Without a major upgrade, the jet risks being trapped in the past, unable to keep pace with the threats that are coming. That's where Technology Refresh 3, or TR3, comes in. Think of it as open-heart surgery for the world's most advanced fighter. New processors, expanded memory, next-generation displays, a complete overhaul of the jet's digital nervous system. And the specially instrumented F-35 at Edwards Air Force Base is the one tasked with proving it works. The stakes couldn't be higher. Every future upgrade to the F-35, what's known as Block 4, depends entirely on TR-3. Without it, there are no new long-range missiles, no advanced sensors, no revolutionary electronic warfare systems. But with it, the possibilities expand dramatically. That's why this test jet is more than just another aircraft. It's the bridge between today's F-35 and the fighter it must become. A fighter not just built for 2025, but for 2035 and beyond. And if TR-3 succeeds, the F-35 won't just remain relevant. It could evolve into something far more dangerous than its designers originally imagined. So why build this strange, sensor-covered F-35 in the first place? Because the future of air combat is about to change, and the weapons designed for it don't even exist on today's battlefield. The U.S. Air Force isn't content with the bombs and missiles the jet already carries. With TR-3 in place, the door opens to an entirely new arsenal. We're talking about long-range air-to-air missiles like the AIM-260, designed to outclass anything in Russian or Chinese inventories. We're talking about advanced electronic warfare pods, systems that can blind enemy radars and shut down communications before a single shot is fired. And there are whispers of even more ambitious projects, prototypes of hypersonic weapons that could one day turn the F-35 into a launch platform for speeds no enemy defense can catch. But none of this is ready yet. These are experimental systems, concepts still on the drawing board, weapons that have never been tested in real combat. That's why the Air Force needs this one-of-a-kind F-35. It's the crucible where those ideas are tested, refined, and either proven or broken. Every mission this jet flies isn't about destroying targets. It's about gathering the data that will make these future weapons possible. In a way, it's like watching the blueprint of tomorrow's wars being written in real time, inside a single aircraft. And for America's adversaries, that's the most terrifying part, because they don't know exactly what this jet will unleash. They only know it's coming. The arrival of this test F-35 may seem like just another step in a long development program, but the truth is, its impact could ripple across the globe. Because the F-35 isn't just an American fighter, it's an international system. Over a dozen allied nations fly it, from Europe to Asia, and every one of them is counting on these upgrades to keep their fleets at the cutting edge. That means whatever happens inside this one aircraft at Edwards Air Force Base will eventually define the future of entire air forces. Allies will train differently, weapon stockpiles will shift, and the strategies of NATO and other US partners will adapt around the new capabilities the jet unlocks. But while allies prepare to integrate these upgrades, rivals are watching with unease. Russia is betting on its Su-57. China is racing ahead with the J-20. Both know that the F-35 is already difficult to counter. And once TR-3 and Block 4 are fully operational, that challenge becomes even greater. They may not know exactly what weapons or systems are coming, but they understand one thing. The United States is building a fighter designed not just for today's wars, but for the wars of tomorrow. And that creates a dangerous paradox. The more advanced the F-35 becomes, the more pressure adversaries feel to catch up or to strike before they fall too far behind. In that sense, this single test jet isn't just shaping technology. It's shaping strategy, deterrence, and the balance of power itself. The question now is whether America's rivals can keep pace or if the future of the skies is already decided. And that brings us to the final question. What will the F-35 look like 10 years from now? With Technology Refresh 3 and the coming Block 4 upgrades, this aircraft could evolve into something far beyond what we imagine today. Not just a fighter built to win battles, but a system designed to shape them before they even begin. Think about it. An aircraft that doesn't just survive the battlefield, but bends it to its will. A jet that carries weapons no one has seen, runs on software no rival can match, and links entire fleets into a single, unstoppable network. That's the promise. But there's also a risk, because every leap forward carries the weight of cost, complexity, and uncertainty. So when we look at this single, strange, sensor-covered F-35 at Edwards Air Force Base, we may not just be watching another test flight. We may be staring at the outline of the future, an aircraft that could redefine air power or collapse under the pressure of its own ambition. And that leaves us with the ultimate question. What do you think this new F-35 will become? A weapon beyond imagination, or a project that promises too much and delivers too little? If you want to follow the evolution of the world's most advanced fighter and the battles it's being built to win, make sure you're subscribed to Umbra Warfare, because the story of the F-35 isn't over. In many ways, it's only just beginning.